Hello students, today we'll discuss on a new topic, that is grader. The motor grader or road grader are usually termed as a grader. The main function of the grader is to cut, lift and grade to a desired profile of any area or road. Broadly speaking, the motor grader moves or rather than remove the dirt. This task is accomplished with the help of a long curved section, hardened blade with renewable bottom and end cutting edge. The blade movements are three types: up and down, sideways and rotational. The mold board is fastened to a circle by means of a circle nisp. A matched tilting rack is provided on the circle knee to allow the blade to lift forward or backward with relation to the circle nisp. The pitch of the mold board should be such that it gives the cutting edge at the bottom proper penetration while at the same time keeping the dirt rolling. If the blade is too forward and the cutting edge does not have the proper time cutting angle and will drag along the ground instead of entering it easily. If the blade is pitched too far back, the material will hang onto the mold board and will be then dragged forward instead of rolling up and mold board freely as it should. The grader can be classified in the following manner. Number one is self-powered grader and number two is torque grader.
Self-powered grader. Picture
shows the self-powered grader. The whole unit is mounted on six pneumatic wheels. Of these, four wheels are placed close to each other while the remaining two wheels are same distance apart. The main frame, which is mounted on the wheel assembly, is peculiar in shape, an inverted U-shape with inclined wheels. The engine and the power transmission system are placed over the four wheel assembly zone, which is at the rear side of the equipment. Two wheel assembly unit is placed at the front, which is also connected to the steering system of this equipment. The long curved blade operates between the two and four wheel assembly unit. The blade is attached to a circle which is in constant mesh with the pinion and is also attached to the operation system. So this is a self-powered grader. Next is torque gear. Torque gear grader have no prime mover or transmission of their own. They are attached at the rear end of a tractor and are pulled by it. This is additional attached to the tractor unit. The picture shows such a grader. The grader unit is usually mounted on three wheels. The adjoining diagram shows the tractor seal, which is at the rear side. The winch hoist control and lifting mechanism are placed in front of the operator seat. The main frame consists of an inverted U-shaped framework, which is mounted on the toad wheel. A drawbar attached at the bottom of the frame holds the circle. The blade is mounted on the circle. So this is the torque grader. Another grader type is hydraulic operated grader. Picture shows the hydraulic operated grader. Here, the blade operation and steering of machine are achieved by hydraulic means. Other systems such as the engine and the power transmission system remain the same as the rules of the mechanical operated grader. Now comes to the component of the grader: blade and circle, transmission, steering system, blade control unit and brake system. First is coming to the blade. The blade is curved with the cutting edge at the bottom and has two corner pieces at the side. The width of the blade is less in comparison with that of a dozer blade. Circle and blade. The circle is a machine jig with gear teeth on the inner surface. The blade consists of curved mold board of approximated dimension 3,710 × 620 × 19 mm with replaceable edges on the sides and buttons. This has a heavy back reinforcement with a which is machined to form rail that can slide through supporting brackets fastened to back welded to the lowered surface of the circle. The lift arms are fastened to each side of the drawbar of the rear and are operated by crank and the frame. These cranks are turned by heavy duty shaft. In some latest design, these arms are of the telescopic type, thereby extending and retracting the circle, which helps in raising or lowering the blade. So these are the blade. Next is power transmission system. Power from the engine is transmitted through a weight multiple disc clutch and coupling to the gearbox. Power from the gearbox is taken in a differential throughout universal joint and a propeller shaft. The differential distributed power on the left and right hand side as the situation demands to the tandem drive sprocket. Here there are two sprockets on each side on and each of them delivers power to wheel individually, rough and endless chain and sprocket arrangement. The system operates at six different speeds, both for reverse and forward. Travel speed range from 3.5 to 51.6 km per hour. There are two other variations of power transmission also available for the motor transmission. Number one is power train with tandem drives. Number two is power train with all drive. The figure shows the diagram of the such transmission system. The crankshaft of the engine transmits power to the gearbox, input shaft, throttle clutch, propeller shaft and coupling. There is a clutch mounted on the input shaft of the gearbox. This clutch can be shifted right or left to mesh different gear tubes so that different speed could be achieved at the output shaft of the gearbox. This output shaft is connected to the input shaft of the final drive throttle propeller shaft. The final drive consists of a pair of bevel gear arranged at right angle and a pair of spur gears. Power from input shaft to final drive finally arrives at the driving wheel through bevel gear, spur gear and provided driven to the motor rider. So this is the power train with a tandem drive. After powertrain with tandem drive, next is powertrain. Is to rear differential. This differential drives the rear wheel. Thus, all wheels of the motor grid receive power. So, this is the powertrain of all wheel-driven motor grader. Next is mechanically operated grader. Steering system. When the steering wheel is rotated, the shaft of the steering system is rotated either clockwise or counterclockwise. The motion is transmitted through the gearbox to the vertical shaft. An arm mounted on the vertical shaft operates a ball joint. The ball joint in turn helps in steering the machine by changing the direction of the wheel through two tie rods. Here the picture shows the schematic diagram of the steering system. Next is blade control unit. The blade control units. C types up and down, sideways and rotational. up and down and sideways, the above movement is done by the operating a lever which transfers the effort through a control panel, universal joint, primary and secondary gear box to the arm or crank. The arm is thus rotated either clockwise or counterclockwise, as a result of which the blade experiences lateral and vertical shifting movement. Next is rotational movement of a blade. The effort of the lever passes through a control level panel, universal joint, primary gearbox, universal joint and secondary gearbox to the pinion. The pinion is in constant mesh with the inner teeth of the circle. The rotation of the pinion provides rotational motion of the circle, which is turn tailwind rotation the plate. Here the picture shows the rotational movement of a blade.
This is hydraulically operated grader. This type of grader is aided by a hydraulic circuit. This is picture shown in this figure. This consists of two gear pump of a capacity 2 into 37.5 liter at 1800 rpm, joined in parallel being 175 kg per centimeter square. When the pressure exceeds the limit, the hydraulic oil is returned back to the tank till the pressure arrives at the predetermined value. Oil from the pressure relief valve is allowed to pass through a control valve bank. The control valve bank consists of three valves: steering control valve, blade rotation valve and blade lifting valve. Each of the valve is operated separately by the operator. The steering valve operated the steering cylinder. The blade rotation valve sends oil to the hydraulic motor, while the blade lifting valve sends oil to the lift cylinder. Oil sends oil to the lift cylinder accordingly. So this is the hydraulic circuit of the hydraulically operated grader. Next one is brake system. So two types of brake are used. One is parking brake, second one is service brake. Parking brake, this is a mechanical brake applied on the output shaft of the transmission or gearbox. It is an internal expanding type. Number two is service brake. This is gradual hydraulically actuated brake applied on all the wheels. It is an internal expanding type. In the servo system, compressed air is allowed to flow and push the piston of the master cylinder, which apply the brake through hydraulic fluid pressure. This type of brake system has already been discussed in this chapter of the damper. So up to here you can learn about the grader, its classification and its components. Thank you.